from the Masters. Tapping into the Power of Love. Written by Brian Weiss, MD. And read by the author with Carol Weiss.
For those of you meeting me for the first time, a few words of introduction are needed. I am Dr. Brian Weiss, and I have come a long way from that fateful day when I, a classically trained physician, professor of psychiatry, and confirmed skeptic, realized that human life is grander and more profound than even my rigorous medical training had led me to believe. Educated as an academic, I received my undergraduate degree from Columbia University and my medical degree from the Yale University School of Medicine, where I was also the chief resident in psychiatry. I have been on the teaching faculties of several university medical schools, and for 11 years, I served as chairman of the Department of Psychiatry at Mount Sinai Medical Center in Miami Beach, Florida. By the time I first met Catherine, the patient whose story is told in my first program, Many Lives, Many Masters, I had published more than 40 scientific papers and book chapters, and I had achieved international recognition in the fields of psychopharmacology and brain chemistry. Not surprisingly, I was completely skeptical of unscientific fields such as parapsychology. I knew nothing about the concept of past lives or reincarnation, nor did I want to. And then came my sudden and shocking introduction to the spiritual, the right brain, the nonlinear. Catherine inexplicably began recalling what seemed to be past life memories. Somehow, all of her clinical symptoms improved via this regression process. I was amazed. This new program represents the culmination of 20 years of experience and studies, not only with reincarnation, but in the movement known as New Age. It is my attempt to remind you about love and joy and to teach you how to bring these qualities into your life now, while you are in a physical state. You will learn techniques for achieving levels of inner peace and happiness that may be lacking in your present lives. You will find a great deal of material here about the nature of the soul, about immortality, and about values. There are many practical tips and techniques for transforming your life, your relationships, your moods and mental states, your physical health and well-being, and your destiny. Knowledge of past lives is not necessary to achieve these positive changes. The ultimate key is understanding. As you understand your true nature and your true purpose, your life will be permanently transformed, and then you can begin to transform the world. We are swimming in a sea of New Age, holistic, and spiritual awareness that seems to have flooded over the dams of old beliefs and of constricted consciousness. The evidence is everywhere. New thought is becoming mainstream. The National Institutes of Health is funding studies in acupuncture, herbal medicine, hypnosis, and altered states of consciousness. Insurance companies are covering alternative and complementary healing techniques. Old line advertising companies are promoting commercial products with international campaigns that feature reincarnation as a selling tool. Movies and television programs trumpet New Age themes to millions of interested viewers. Why is this happening? For several hundred years, people have mistakenly believed that technology, once fully developed, would solve the ills of mankind, that science would provide the path out of the woods, away from illness, poverty, misery, and pain. We now know that technology and science alone are not capable of solving our problems. Only when used with enlightenment, wisdom, and balance can technology truly help us. We must find the right balance. Love is the fulcrum of this balance. It is also the ultimate healer. I hope that this program will teach you how to recognize love, how to cultivate and enlarge your experience of love, especially toward yourself and in relationships, and how to manifest and radiate your love to others. By doing so, you will inevitably experience more joy, health, and happiness in your life. The cycle of life. Our lives are not the result of random actions and events. Lifetimes are wisely and carefully scripted to enhance our learning and evolution. We choose our parents, who usually are souls with whom we have interacted in prior lifetimes. We learn as children, adolescents, and adults, evolving spiritually as our bodies evolve physically. After our souls leave our bodies at the time of physical death, our learning continues on higher planes, which are really higher levels of consciousness. We review the lives we have just left, learn our lessons, and plan for our next life. Learning does not end with the death of the body. There are many levels of consciousness that we visit when our soul departs the physical body. One important level is the learning stage, where we review our lives. We re-experience every encounter, every relationship. We feel the emotions of the people whom we have helped or hurt, loved and hated, or affected positively or negatively. We feel their emotions very deeply because this is a powerful learning device, a sort of instant, intense feedback about our behavior while we were on Earth in physical bodies. We learn through relationships, and thus it is important that we understand how we have touched others. The concept of reincarnation explains and clarifies our present life relationships. Often events in the distant past are still influencing current relationships. Becoming aware of the root causes in prior lives can heal the relationship in the present. Awareness and understanding are powerful healing forces. Let me begin with an extended yet fascinating case study that involves a present lifetime and also past lives. It explains in part the process of regression therapy and also powerfully demonstrates the pathways of our souls. I had been asked by a major television news show to participate in a segment and demonstrate past life regression to its vast viewing audience. Hearing about the project and interested in my work, a well-known news reporter named Andrea volunteered to be the patient for the taped segment. For this regression, I used the technique known as progressive relaxation, a gentle and gradual descent into the hypnotic state. Andrea's session was dramatic, vivid, and intense. She was able to experience childhood, prenatal, and past life memories, and her life and relationships benefited as a result. The taping took place in a downtown New York apartment cluttered with television cameras and crew. In the beginning, Andrea merely listened as I gently instructed her how to reach the deep hypnotic state. "The goal is to get comfortable," I began. "It's going to be done with your eyes closed. So all you have to do is really follow the directions. Is that okay?" Andrea nodded yes. She was starting to relax. "Good. There are faster ways, but I want you to experience the relaxation procedure too. So you're letting your eyes gently close, and the rest of the session will be with your eyes closed. Focus first on your breathing. This is an ancient way for going within. Some people call this yoga breathing. The breath is very important. Just imagine, and don't hesitate to use your imagination today, that you can actually breathe out the tensions and stresses in your body, and that you can breathe in the beautiful energy all around you, breathing out stress and tension, breathing in beautiful energy. This will help you to go deeper and deeper with each breath. You'll be able to focus on my voice, and let my voice carry you deeper as well. But let background noises or any other distractions only deepen your level even more. They won't interfere. You can go deep enough today to have wonderful experiences. Her breathing was becoming slower and deeper. I could tell she was already sinking into a deep trance level. I could hear the camera operators behind me scurrying to adjust.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.